Look at her.
Oh, Miss Roxy. Now let me tell you about Roxy.
That's my sister. We have a relationship kind of like me and Alyssa's. Mm-hmm. Me and Roxy will fight, and then we'll be like, okay, girl, now we done fighting, let's go eat. We are
just that close. Roxy,
and she was so, I asked her after All-Stars, I said, girl, why were you really so worried about sending me home? And also, she said, I really, really thought that I was gonna lose my friendship because, you know, she lives still in Florida and I live in Vegas, so we hadn't seen each other as much, so we didn't have that connection. So she was worried about it, and I was like, Roxy, it's okay. It's totally fine. It's not that big of a deal. And I think that she's absolutely amazing.
And she's still pageanting it up, right?
Oh, yeah. Pageanting it up. She's still painting the house down and pageanting it up. She's been Miss Continental Plus. I mean, she's been doing everything. So.
Yeah. Now, what's something we don't know about Roxy?
Ooh, Roxy, when she's a boy, let me tell you, Roxy and this one, you know, like this one posts pictures. Roxy posts pictures like that too. So if you ever go to her Instagram or her Facebook, you'll find those pictures.
She just mad because she can't do it.
No, I can't. I'm too old. Girl, I look like E.T. When I get out of drag, I'm lucky I found me a husband that loves me for my look.
Because she said the hell
sometimes my boy elude and I'm almost.
No, you're
I'm
good out
50.
Of drag. Her
I'm
trade is
50,
right.
So.
She dresses down, wears the like hottest fashion.
Yeah.
It's right.
But I'm a little bit, you know, so I kind of look a little bit like E.T. E.T. is my favorite, though. I'm not mad about it. He celebrated his 50-year anniversary of that movie.
That's E.T. right, and all the Reese's Pieces you can eat.
Exactly. Now phone that home.
All right, look at him.
Your biggest
sister.
Miss Derek Berry.
I met Derek the same day I met you.
Yep. You met Derek. Mm-hmm. And it's so funny because you didn't become Kahana Berry. You became Coco Montrese.
Uh-huh. No, Derek is very much like an auntie for me. Her and Alexis, I look up to them for so much advice. I think it's just more of the like sisterhood that she has or they have with Coco. And they want to make sure like, okay. That's
we
family.
We take care of the baby.
We gonna take care of her. You know, so she's always been that way with me. Derek has, like, every time I called her when I got back from Drag Race, she's one of the first girls I saw because, you know, we did the challenge together. So she really helped me get over, like a really dark time because I struggled with my elimination.
Right.
And she was the first person to pick me up from that. And, like, that day I shook it off. I was like, I'm second, but I'm still a bad bitch because Derek Berry fucking told me I was that bitch. You know what I mean?
Right.
Like, he's very much that type of person.
And before Derek was on Drag Race, Derek and his partner at the time helped film my video to go to Drag Race.
Wow.
They were the force behind it going, you have got to do this. You're doing this. Because Derek and I were in the show in Vegas together, and Derek was like, no, you got to go do this. And he wasn't even on Drag Race yet. So he was like, you got to do this. You got to do this. And I was like, Derek, I don't know about the reality TV thing. He's like, well, you about to find out. So he actually, through the editing and everything, put everything together. He came over to my house because I had this condo on the strip because I was grand like that. Mm-hmm. And he set up all the cameras, videotaped me, and everything, and got me ready for Drag Race.
Wow.
He sure did.
That's family.
Yeah.
Yes. Look at her.
Let's
love Enrique.
Let's not look at her. Let's not.
No, I'm just kidding. He's right there. She's right there.
let's not look at her. No.
That's auntie for real. That's okay. Alexis is the type of auntie who you go and you try to like call, be like, hey, can we go party? Can we go out? Because, you know, mama ain't gonna let me out. But she'll end up partying with you and videotape the whole thing and tell it to, and show the videos to your mama.
Oh, she's sending them to me while you guys are out.
Oh, yeah, very bad. She is like the setup queen, honey. No, she's cool.
But you know what? She's so amazing. Alexis is amazing. She's an amazing artist. What I love about her, people don't know, we worked at Disney together for years.
Right, and she said you wouldn't reveal what character you were.
Well, not me, but I'll tell you what she did.
Mm-hmm.
A whole new world. She rode on magic carpets.
Uh-huh. And she wasn't a girl. So, do the math.
But you know what, Alexis? It was so fun. We had great times at Disney, and we learned... that's where we learned our craft so well. We were able to do that, and then we did drag at night, and then we went back to work at Disney in the daytime.
And how has it been seeing Alexis take a step back out into public life recently and get back on the road?
I'm so glad to see her back out there. I'm so glad to see, because she has so much to offer. She has so much to offer. She's one of the most talented queens I know.
I think it's overdue. For so long, she gives so much of her, not only herself, her advice, her time, her support to
everybody,
single girl, queen, male performer. She will help. And I feel like she was putting a lot of people first that she neglected herself.
Yeah.
And to finally see her get the shine that she deserves is so, I'm like so ecstatic for her. Because she's going to take over the world. Because now it's about Alexis, finally.
Yeah.
Love it.
Bam, bitches!
Bam! We love you, Alexis.